Hello and assalamu alaikum. I hope each and every one of you will be doing great. So in lecture number 16, I was discussing about different types of photovoltaic cells or solar cells, and we will continue with that in this part of the lecture. So this is lecture number 17, and in this part of the lecture I will discuss about the concentration cells. In concentration cells, sunlight is focused on a small area by a low cost lens that is 10 to 100 times more intense than the regular sunlight without focusing. Area requirement for required energy capacity significantly reduced, leading to significant reduction in the material that is used in the construction of photovoltaic cells. Cell conversion efficiency increases under concentrated sunlight because more photons are focused basically on the solar cell. 37% efficiency have been achieved for terrestrial applications using a cell previously designed for the space applications. The main disadvantage for using concentration cell is that the concentrating optics, the glass that is used to concentrate the photons on the photovoltaic cell, add cost increase in price is noted. So this is an example of a lens that is basically concentrating the sunlight that falls directly onto this lens, and the sunlight is converged on a single photovoltaic cell, and the concentration ratio is given by the formula area of the lens divided by the area of the cell. Concentration photovoltaic cells, also known as concentration photovoltaics, is a photovoltaic technology that is capable of generating electricity from sunlight. And unlike conventional photovoltaic systems, it uses lenses or curved mirrors to focus a sunlight onto a small area, which increases its efficiency. Multi-junction solar cell are projected against the converged sunlight, and more electricity can be produced. In addition, concentrated photovoltaic systems often use solar trackers and sometimes cooling systems to further increase their efficiency, because focusing of sunlight to a certain point may also increase the amount of heat that is being produced. Ongoing research and development is rapidly improving their competitiveness in the utility scale segment and in the areas of insulation. Systems using high concentration photovoltaics or photovoltaic systems especially have the potential to become competitive in the near future. They process the highest efficiency of the existing photovoltaic technologies that are available in the market, and a smaller photovoltaic array also reduces the balance of the system costs. Currently, concentrated photovoltaic technology is far less common as compared to the conventional photovoltaic system, and has only recently been made available to the residential market. The first residential installation is a 1.6 kilowatt system in California by Radical Sun Systems. Modern concentrated photovoltaic systems operate most efficiently in highly concentrated sunlight, that is concentration levels equivalent to the hundreds of sun. As long as solar cell is kept cool through the use of heat sinks, diffused light which occurs in cloudy and overcast conditions cannot be highly concentrated using the conventional optical components only, that like microscopic lens and mirrors. Filtered light, which occurs in hazy or polluted conditions, has spectral variations, which produces mismatch between electrical currents generated within the series connected junctions, especially the tuned multi-junction photovoltaic cell. These concentrated photovoltaic features lead to rapid decrease in power output when the atmospheric conditions are, let's say, cloudy or less than ideal. To produce equivalent or greater energy per rated watt that the as compared to the conventional photovoltaic system, concentrated photovoltaic systems must be located in the areas that receive plentiful direct sunlight, like in deserts. This is typically specified as an average direct normal irradiance greater than 5.5 to 6 kilowatt per meter square per day, or approximately 2000 kilowatt hour per meter square per year. Otherwise, evaluation of annualized DNI versus global normalization indices and global horizontal irradiance data. Irradiance data concludes that the conventional photovoltaic systems should still perform better over time than presently available concentrated photovoltaic technologies in most regions of the world. But let's hope that with the passage of time, this technology gets better and the concept of concentrated sunlight on a smaller area to produce larger electric currents may prevail.